Hi, I'm Ethel Dacosta, and we are on day 3 of Goa Fest 2018 at the Grand Hyatt. I just came out from a exciting, assertive interview done with Sania Mirza, the tennis legend, who spoke passionately about the sport, how it has made her a better human, a better person, her entire strength that she draws from the sport that she loves, a little bit of her family, and how her father always was very proud of them as daughters and never kind of missed out on not having sons, her experiences traveling the world representing India and being such a role model to young Indian women. There's so much more coming up in the interview soon.
As an athlete, you don't actually pay so much attention on to who you are playing. You have to pay attention. Yes, you do come out with strategy and your team does that. They scout and they, today with YouTube is so easy to, watch matches and obviously. But the more important thing is to have a belief within yourself, no matter who you're playing. It doesn't need to be, Serena, it could be someone who's 500 in the world. You still have to win the match and the match is between you. It's between, it's about the tennis ball and to hit the ball over the net, and that is something that is as basic as it sounds, but it really is. And you have to focus on yourself, you have to focus on what your strengths are. I mean, everybody has weaknesses, but you have to believe that your strengths are better than theirs, and that's the only way that you have a chance to win, if at all, whoever you are playing.
Put your mind game as well. So what's your mantra before taking on that match to be fully mentally prepared for the battle?
Well, I think, like I said, I can't stress enough on belief. I think that is something that we have to understand, that if you don't believe, it never will happen. And hence the hashtag of every girl can, that is a belief that I have. And if you don't believe that, whether you do it or not is secondary, but the belief needs to be there. So I think that is something that you kind of psych yourself up. You sit with your team, you talk to them, you talk about what you do best in pressure situations. And I personally like pressure, as weird as that sounds, but I guess when you win matches and stuff, you have to like that pressure, because if you don't like that pressure, you're not going to be able to perform at your best in very high pressure situations. So that's what tennis has actually taught me in life as well, that no matter how bad it is, it's going to end, and there's going to be another day, as long as you want there to be one, So that is something that I live by, and that's what I think every time I go to a match, that the worst thing that can happen is that you can lose. I mean, what else is going to happen? Then you can come back the next day and it's over and you try to win the next tournament.
That is the fighter spirit that resonates with each and every statement that you make. But also when it comes to fighting those battles, and you've talked a lot about how sports makes one a better human being. And I think that is one of the many statements that, tells us that,
I think that sport is, everybody's not a champion, like it's not about becoming a champion. Sport is not about you play a sport only to become a champion. That's not how it is. That's not how I started either. And most successful people will tell you that it's not how they started. They will always tell you that we started because we love the game. And sport, it's incredible. It teaches you life skills. It teaches you how to cope with wins. It teaches you how to cope with losses, more importantly. It obviously is healthy. So I feel that we... especially in this part of the world, we sort of lack that sporting culture, right? Like, we don't understand the importance of sport as much as we understand the importance of studies, but it's actually as important. It's important to go out and play and let your kids go out and play instead of being on the phone or on an iPad.
Are we doing better on that front, you think, over the last few years, or still a long way to go?
I think there's more kids holding iPads and iPhones today than there were like 5 years ago. But I think that we are doing better as a whole, as a country, to promote sport. I think that we made a big difference after the Commonwealth Games, after we hosted them. I think that people really I feel like most people used to think that, cricket is the only thing that we're really good at and everything else we're just, okay and average. But I think after the Commonwealth Games and seeing the champions that came out and the amount of medals we won, I think today, hence, at the Commonwealth Games that's happening in Gold Coast, people are paying attention a lot more to it. You have it's coming live, and you see every morning there's front pages of people winning gold medals. And I think that happened a lot because we hosted Commonwealth Games, where people got to see the actual champions that we have in every other sport as well.